Hello students, in last lecture we have all done this. Now we are continuing with the next thing, that is the definitiveness of ethical human conduct. How we have already done the some definite characteristic of the pranic order as well as our material order, right, and animal order. In case of when we talk about the pranic order, all of we know neem tree will have neem tree seeds will have the characteristic of neem only. Mango tree seeds, when we you put into the soil, then that will the mangoes come, that has the characteristics of mangoes. The cow has the characteristic definite characteristics of the cow, but in human it is not necessary. We have to, what we are learning, we have to inculcate the definitiveness of human conduct so that we can develop the ethical human conduct, right? With the help of right understanding gained through self-exploration, enable us to identify the definitiveness of human conduct, because we don't have actually, right? That's why we are and again we are saying that with the help of self-exploration we have to develop this, with the self-exploration we have to work this, right? What is the ethical human conduct? You have the ethical human conduct which is in consonance with the human values, right? That is in consonance of the with the universal human values. There is no need of debate and anything that what is the human values, right? We are continuously seeing that we are living with the our preconditioning assumption. We are still not in the consonance of truth and right understanding, right? How we have work on the our natural acceptance, we divide it into the three parts. First one is the values. What are the values? Values are part of ethical human conduct. How values will come? With the help of realization and understanding, which is always definite. Always definite. When you realize the things, what you are doing, what you are on what thing you are working, then you will realize that and develop your value. Second thing is the policy, niti. When you are develop the, you are going to develop the ethical sense in all levels, in all things, right? In that case, you obviously adopt some policies which is conducive to human welfare. For example, when you are running some business, in that case you will take care for that there must not be a pollution. For that you will follow some policy, and or which profession you on which profession you have to work, which profession you follow, in that case you have to follow some policies. That is called the niti. Third thing, when you have the values, when you have the policies, there is a definiteness in your living also, right? When you have the definiteness in living and that comes from your behavior and work, then obviously you have the definite human conduct in terms of values, policies and character, right? In case of character, you have to do the right production, acquisition, utilization of wealth, right? That called the prosperity. You have the human behavior and work with kindness, right? Human conduct basically conduct on the basis of the following: ethical conduct, naturally acceptable by all, no conflict, not inside conflict, not outside conflict. Ethical conduct, consonance with right understanding, reality, the understanding, the harmony at all levels. It leads to mutual fulfillment with other people, mutual enrichment with the rest of nature. So, on the basis of that, we can realize that ethical conduct is self-satisfying, people-friendly, eco-friendly. That is the definite human conduct. That we have already done in the starting of when we do the self-exploration, identification of Swat. Here we are revising that again because how we develop the ethical human conduct, for that we need the Swatv. How Swatv will come? All of you know, when you have explored the things with the help of your natural acceptance, right? At the different levels of living. Four levels of living we have done, right? Self, after that family, society, and nature, right? In all levels of living, when you explore the things with the help of natural acceptance, that is called the Swatv. You live accordingly your Swatv, that help us to attain you Swatantrata. What is the Swarajya? When you are more organized, you are able to live in harmony with other orders and also help others to participate in it. Helping others how they do work, that is called the Swarajya, because all natural acceptance are same. There is no need for the another thing. Development of human consciousness. All things are developed through the right understanding only. There is no other way for the development of other thing. When you have the right understanding, you will not running towards the physical thing, because when we are running towards the physical things, then it is the animal consciousness, right? When you have the right understanding, you able to give the do the correct appraisal of your physical needs, right? In that case, what happen? You move from animal consciousness to the human consciousness. That is necessary to develop. We have to align our activities in the light of right understanding. We have to give priority to our relationships, then physical facilities, and do the correct appraisal. Implications of value-based living. First, we will see at the level of individual. What work I have to do at the level of individual? Getting rid of contradictions, whatever conflicts within me, that we must remove. We have to attain a state in which I explore the all questions, question answers in myself only. There is no need of other person to explore myself, right? Then I also get rid of depression, frustration, and other situations, right? The feeling of sanyam that we have to develop to take care of our body, because body is an instrument of I, right? I react, I work with the help of body, right? At the level of individual, we have to do the right understanding so that we can attain a state to getting the our answers from myself only, right? When we talk about family, in case of family, what we need? Mutual fulfillment in the relationships. All peoples must feel prosperous, feeling of to nurture others will grow in family. When we see there is a no conflict in our family, that is nowadays very big problem. We have the harmony also. We don't have the competitive feeling. We don't have the consumeric behavior in our families. Then we can say we are doing the mutual fulfillment in the family also. Third thing, at the level of society. At the level of society, when we come, when we are giving higher priority to the relationships, we are not giving higher priority to the physical facilities. We are not judging people with the help of gender, age, race, ki he has more money, we are giving preference to them. We are not doing. There are so many societal problems, terrorism, nationalism. If we have the good understanding, then we can talk with each other and after that resolve the problem. This is just misunderstanding. That's why these problems are in the society. All problems can be resolved with the in the light of right understanding when we explore the things. Last but not least, at the level of nature, we have the relation with the nature, right? The problems, pollution, resource depletion are the physical facilities which we are depleting. We are not taking care for that. We are not using in the cyclic manner. We are not doing the better farming production for these things. That's why we are facing the problem. We are just cutting the forest, right? That is the, if we will take care of all these things at four levels of our living, these are the four levels of our living, then obviously we will able to achieve the ethical human conduct. That is the universal to all, that is same for all. Thank you, students. In next chapter, we are doing the basis for holistic alternative towards the universal human order. I hope you try to inculcate the thing that is natural characteristic of your, that is not look like the imposed thing, right? Thank you, students.